Now, first off, if what I'm about to say offends you, I'm sorry and I apologize. And I'm apologizing not because I feel guilty or I'm scared of you or I think I'm offensive. I'm apologizing because you are a crybaby and you don't know how to tolerate people's opinions. And if you don't agree with something, educate. If you can't educate, then don't cry over it. And if you want to cry over it, you have the floor to cry over it. But don't expect me to apologize. Thank you. Yeah. So, today, I had a conversation with an Albanian. And he actually walked up to me, he wasn't even a conversation, he actually walked up to me and he was like, yo, ADB, I'm sorry, you know, Albanians are good people and all that, I know you're from Ghana and you are good people, so what I'm about to say, don't be offended. So I was like, okay, I mean, I don't get what you mean, but anyway, I'm an open-minded person, I'll never be offended. So, yeah, he told me the story about an Albanian 26-year-old who wanted to get married to a Ghanaian lady in, I think, in the United Kingdom. And I think it has to do with getting permanent stay papers and all that. And, you know, the guy had to fly the lady to Albania, so he meets his family and, you know, get to know each other before they get engaged and married. So I heard that after 2 days or 3 days, they had a fight, I mean, couples fight all the time, and he stabbed the lady, and the lady was being rushed to the hospital by the guy's neighbor, and the guy committed suicide. And the lady died shortly before or after the suicide incident. And being from Ghana, I thought that, hey, let me go check it out. And I went to check it out. And that's what I found. So the screenshot I just posted is from the Albanian Daily News. It's a blog. And the caption of the story is that new details over couple's death in Tirana. Tirana, I heard, is the capital of Albania, and I'm not sure, but I think I'll have to look that up. And it's the capital of Albania, and it looks like that's where they used to live, and the couple used to live in an Airbnb apartment. So this is how the story was reported on the Albanian Daily News. So as I read, Clayton Pira and Ibanian Josaki Jabwa, who died tragically this Saturday, have been in a cohabitation relationship since January this year. AlbaniaDailyNews.com link. Anyway, I think the name was butchered, but yeah, I get it. I mean, Albania is a country in the Europe, and they don't speak English, so yeah. English is not their second language, so yeah, I get it. So, I mean, if they are not Ghanaian, so if they butcher the name, I mean, it's allowed too. And, let's continue. So, they crashed in a rented apartment on Peter Bully Street in Tirana. Yeah, as I said earlier, then Tirana is the capital of Albania. A 26-year-old from Ibra, first shot the Ghanaian with a knife and then jumped from the eighth floor. I'm sure the editor or whoever translated the story wanted to say stop with a knife. I mean, nobody stops. Nobody shoots with a knife. Anyway, but it's allowed. English is not your first language, as I said earlier. And actually, no one gets accolades for speaking good English. I mean, you could get accolades for speaking good English, but I mean, as far as it doesn't bring any money to you. Maybe it's a waste of time or whatever. Anyway, I digress and don't take my word for it though. It's just an opinion. She has moved in Albania to live with her new boyfriend as they shared photos and love messages appear on latter Facebook pages. The 26-year-old died immediately while the Ghanaian with a French passport was sent to the hospital but couldn't survive these injuries. Okay, so this is the story of a Ghanaian diasporan with a French passport who fell in love with an Albanian, and relationship happened, crime of passion. I don't know what happened. I don't know the details and the facts in the story. I think investigation is ongoing, and all I have to say is that since I'm Ghanaian and this story is from Ghana and it involves a Ghanaian, I thought I shared with you. And since I don't have enough information so far, the only thing I would say is that I send my condolences to the family, and I pray that they are well psychologically. Anyway, thank you. I'm just missing out. Don't get it twisted. I got you covered.